FASTSIGNS franchisees, it's me again. Yesterday, I received this amazing quote in my email from Henry Ford. Well, actually, Henry didn't send it himself, but it was somebody sharing a Henry Ford quote, and here it goes. Anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps learning stays young. The greatest thing in life is to keep your mind young. You know, learning is what keeps the mind young, and a young mind keeps your outlook and your quality of life better. Who wouldn't want that? If you spent much time with me or listening to my videos, you know that I believe there are five common characteristics of all highly successful people. And because I'm in the sign business, had them made into a little kind of cute road sign, which you're seeing right now. And they are positive mental attitude, goal-directed behavior, self-motivation, a sense of urgency, and never stopping learning. And what I teach folks, particularly young folks, whenever I can is, these are all learned skills. We can all develop the skill or the characteristic of a positive mindset. We can develop the skill set of goal-directed behavior, same for self-motivation, sense of urgency, and never stopping learning. So, as Henry Ford says, learning keeps your mind young. And today's video is titled, Stay Young, Keep Learning. I think back to my childhood and what I learned from Dr. Seuss. And here it goes, what I learned from my good friend, Dr. Seuss. The more you read, the more things you'll know. The more that you learn, the more places you'll go. And I just remember loving Dr. Seuss as a kid. More than a decade of structured education, we're talking about elementary school, junior high, high school, college, gives us a blueprint upon which to build a pretty darn good life. But the question is, are you still learning today? And that is what is going to keep our minds young and develop our skill sets and give us more upward mobility and make us better leaders. All those things work together. One of the quotes in our FASTSIGNS International Inspiration Hall is one of my favorites, and that is, leaders are readers. Consistently high performance is driven by continuous improvement. B.B. King said, the beautiful thing about learning is that nobody can take it away from you. Leonardo da Vinci, who is widely considered one of the most diversely talented and knowledgeable individuals to have ever lived, who was known to draw on complex bodies of knowledge to solve specific problems, said, learning never exhausts the mind. Zig Ziglar said, you don't have to be great to start, but you have to start to be great. And that's a good reminder that the only way to never reach your goals is to never start. Do you want to be great at something? Start learning about it. The learning curve is essential to growth. You're always going to encounter a learning curve when you learn something new. It's just one of the requirements of actually learning. The frustrations and the struggles that come with it are also a requirement of learning. As you move up the learning curve, in the beginning it's harder, and it gets to be easier and better. The frustrations and struggles that come with it are also a requirement. The learning curve doesn't mean you should quit. As long as you face the challenges and work through those frustrations of moving up the learning curve, you will make progress. Brian Tracy said, those people who develop the ability to continuously acquire new and better forms of knowledge that they can apply to their work and to their lives will be the movers and shakers in our society. Albert Einstein said, any fool can know, the point is to understand. And learning is all about synthesizing seemingly divergent ideas and data. US President Harry Truman said, it's what you learn after you know it all that counts. Another US president, John F. Kennedy, said, the human mind is our fundamental resource. And sticking with US presidents, Lyndon B. Johnson said, you aren't learning anything when you're talking. All of us, whether we're business owners or managers or parents, are leaders. And John F. Kennedy also said, leadership and learning are indispensable to each other. If we want to be better leaders, we got to keep learning. Richard Branson said, you don't learn to walk by following rules. You learn by doing and falling over. And that kind of goes back to that learning curve, right? You're trying something new. You're not as good at it right away. You fall over a little bit, but you got to fall over a few times, thinking about the analogy of learning to walk as a child in order to get that. Benjamin Franklin said, being ignorant is not so much a shame as being unwilling to learn, right? And so we all need to build that willingness to learn. Oliver Wendell Holmes said, man's mind, once stretched by a new idea, never regains its original dimensions. And T.D. Jakes said, the world is a university and everyone in it is a teacher. Make sure when you wake up in the morning, you go to school. And that's kind of a mindset about wanting to learn each and every day. Because the bottom line is, no thief, however skillful, can rob one of knowledge. And that's why knowledge is the best and safest treasure to acquire. I have often said, read 5 books on any subject and you'll know more on that subject than 99% of all the people you meet. Earl Nightingale said it a little bit differently. He said, if a person will spend 1 hour a day on the same subject for 5 years, that person will be an expert on that subject. So, do you want to be really great at selling or sales management or marketing or finance or leadership? Read 5 books on that subject and learn from them, or spend a mere hour a day learning on that subject. So now I'm going to share 3 techniques to never stop learning. Number 1, read, read, read. Sometimes the best teachers and mentors are books. After all, how else can you absorb someone's entire life's learning in one sitting or in one setting? So here's an idea. If you're ever even thinking about buying a book, just do it. Don't waste time debating it. Don't waste time looking up reviews or asking others for their opinions. Getting even just one idea from a book makes the time and money worthwhile. Idea number 2, embrace the mind of a child. Young children ask why incessantly, and they always want to touch and play with everything. They're curious. This is how they learn about the world. Unfortunately, very often when we grow older, that natural curiosity fades. We become rigid and complacent in our thinking. Try to maintain that playful attitude and childlike curiosity at all times, especially in business. Whenever you see a successful person or a successful company doing something different, think, what do they know that I don't? And how can I do something similarly to innovate? Because the bottom line is, curiosity is the wick in the candle of learning. Idea number 3, put yourself in the hands of a trusted teacher or a trusted mentor. If you think about it, professional athletes, famous musicians, and actors, they all have coaches and advisors. If these people who are experts in their fields have coaches, why shouldn't each of us? So there are 3 great ideas or 3 ways to never stop learning. Just this morning, a quote came across my desk in one of the emails. It's from Dale Carnegie, and he said, improving yourself is a lot more profitable than trying to improve others. And the bottom line is, we can all improve our position in life by never stopping learning. And that is a decision. Thank you.